In this video, I want to share with you how to use the Notepad. Notepad actually is an app that comes in by default with your Android phone. In cases when you don't have it, you can always come to your Play Store and you can go to your Play Store and search for Notepad. And you can see the latest one, which is Smart Note. Which one? This is an ad, but you can check around to see this is Notepad, Simple Notes. You can take on this Notepad, or you can come over to the 2022 version, which is Easy Notes. But for now, let's go with Notepad, and you can just click and install it. It's just 5.7 megabytes. You can click to install. Okay, so once it has finished installation, you can click to open. And how are you? Tap to open, right? So once you are here, you can tap or click the notes above to open it, right? So you can tap to open this. This is your first note. Thank you for downloading this. This is just a message. Have a nice day. So you can decide to save this if you want. You can decide to undo. You can come over to this three dots, and you can see undo all, share, delete, print. You can print all this. You can export to a text file, or you can categorize it to your liking, right? But for now, let's say we are going to create a fresh note, right? So you can come to the plus icon over here at the bottom. You just click, and you can see you put a title. For example, we can make it shopping, right? I mostly use it for during shopping. You can say shopping, and you can enter the list of things that you want to buy. For example, you can say, you can hit enter and type onions. And one good thing about it is that once you are working, it's saving, but you can still save, right? So it's saved, and you can keep writing. Close this because we have saved. You can go to the app menu. So these three lines, we click on it. So we can come to settings, and you can see attach diagnostic info. We can, so theme, you can check out the themes, system themes. You can use dark themes. In dark theme, you can use solarized or white or solarized or light. So whichever one you think you like. Okay, so for now, let's say let's go with system settings, and then you can have password settings. You can password the document if you want. You can set in password by just clicking on this to enable. Right, you can click on set password. You can put in your password and email, so not anyone can access your document in this Notepad. So you can set password. For example, let's say I don't want to set the password. You can still come back to the same three lines. You can come to settings again, and you can say not editing. So for example, you can click, and now here we can enable the save automatic, save note automatically. You can enable this. You can switch save and undo buttons, so you can switch them on. Cursor position in a note, you can enable this or disable accordingly. Show note keyboard, you can enable to show keyboard on the note after entering the note screen, or you can disable that if you want. Open notes in read mode, you can open them in read mode. Keep on screen and disable text autocomplete. You can enable or disable autocomplete from here. Draw lines in background, you can enable drawing lines in background. Line numbers, you can enable if you want. Clickable links, you can enable, but for now, let's say I don't want to enable any clickable link. And then we can go back to the main menu. You can come to notes, and here you are. So this is the notes we are talking about, and you can see the way it has designed the document. Now it enables editing. You can edit, right? You can start listing your items. You can go to the second one, and you can go to the third one just by mere hitting on enter, and you can go to the third one and keep listing. For example, I'll buy onions, and then I'll buy vegetables, and I'll buy carrots. So I'll keep listing all of them under this same title. Once I'm done, I can save, although it's auto saving. And this particular document, I can do quite a lot from here. Let's say we have created this one, and we can create another one by clicking on the post, the addition, and you can search for the existing note from here. Okay, by just coming to the search bar, you can search for shopping, for example, and you can see it over here, and it gives you the date that the last time it is edited, the date and the timing when it was last edited. So you have these three dots. Once you check it, you can sort by different kind of things. You can select all notes If you want, you can import text also. You can export notes to text files. You can do all this with this very Notepad. Alright, so you can import and export text accordingly if you want. You can rate the app, you can check out the trash, and you can have backups, and you can check out the edit categories. You can seek for help if you want. You can check the privacy statement and technical support. Very easy. So ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit on how to use the Notepad free, right? This one is the free version that you've downloaded. There is another version that comes in with the Android phone. So let's try to look at it. In my own case is this one. It came in with the Android phone. So you can just click on it. One of the major difference is that I noticed this one has quite a lot as regards the functions. So you can click on this plus icon to start a new note, and you can bring in to do. Okay. And you can bring in, you can add labels. For example, you can have a particular label and attach it to a particular note. So it makes it easy for you to remember or to see it. And you can add new tag if you don't have, for example, let's say shopping over here. And you can give it a color. You can give it this color, or you can give it another different color, maybe this color, and you can hit on OK. And now you're writing on shopping. Okay, so you can keep writing, and you can list the items you want to buy, for example, soap, oil, and many more. And then you are free to bring in text. You have flexibility with the text. You can bring in different kind of labelings. For example, you can bring in numbering, or you can bring in alphabets, you can bring in bullets, different kind of bullets, and then you can increase or decrease the text accordingly over here. So this one that comes in the default is quite flexible. You can increase or decrease the text as you work with it. So you check the format over here, and you can increase or decrease the text accordingly. So very easy to work with, and once you are done, you can always come over to click on this, and then it's going to save this as your note, and you can come back to the main notes, and you can see it's soap with the label. All right, and you can come over here and search. You can search for a particular note, and you can change the listing. This is right now is set to list view. You can change the from list view to another different view. You can see it now, we've changed it. And you can come to the three lines also to check out the bunch of features. You have the to-dos, you have my favorites, you have items according to levels, according to tags. You can set new tags, and you can come to settings and do quite a lot. For example, enabling watermarks when you export your document. So this is just a bit about how to use the inbuilt one and the downloaded one, right? The ones you install and the one that comes in with the phone. Feel free to try it, and you can easily use this to keep your document. All you need is just to be able to log in, and you can have access from any device. For example, now I have logged in with my Huawei, and you can log in using another device also, and you can have access to all your notes very easily and use them. This is just a bit about how to use Notepad on your phone. Ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoy this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.